Hello everybody, today I'm going to show you how to display scale properly on your monitor and get rid of input lag while playing on lower resolutions. This works on literally every single game if it's set up properly, and it's beneficial if you're a competitive player and you want the least amount of input lag. This is what you need to do. You cannot harm your monitor doing this, but there is a catch. If you set up your custom resolution utility wrong, you could potentially brick your monitor so it doesn't turn on. And the fix for that is you either press a hotkey, which is F8 by default, to restore your default settings, or you have to reboot Windows in safe mode and restart the changes you made, which is very easy to do, so don't get worried if you fuck up something, okay? Now, a lot of monitors can display scale with no issues. I know if you have a G-Sync, unfortunately you're out of luck, they just refuse to display scale. If you have FreeSync, it can work. For example, BenQ XL2546 is a monitor that does display scaling on every resolution very good. It has no issues whatsoever. Then my personal monitor is ViewSonic XG2401. Display scales, no issues whatsoever. So in order to start with this, you need to get a program named Custom Resolution Utility. In order to get Custom Resolution Utility, you need to open this webpage here. The link is going to be down in the description. This is a website where you can download Custom Resolution Utility, and this is the official website of the developer. So you click on this link here, CRU151zip. At least 151 is the current version as of the date I'm recording, and today is 10th October 2021. So you download CRU and save that file wherever you want. I'm gonna put it on desktop for now. And once that's downloaded, you need to extract it. So I'm gonna make a quick folder, name it CRU, and extract everything into the folder. Now, in order to start with display scaling, this is what you do. You open CRU and start adding resolutions. So first you need to identify which one is your main monitor. Now, I only have one monitor connected to my system, so it's gonna be this one. If there's monitors in the list that do not have the bracket saying active, you can click on them and delete them. Those are non-active registry files that are just junk, so you can remove them. Now, in order to start display scaling, this is what you're gonna do. You remove the established resolutions because you don't need them. You remove the detailed resolutions because you also do not need them. You remove standard resolutions also. And if you have extension block, open it, and you're gonna have a bunch of resolutions listed in here. Now, I'm gonna remove everything, I'm gonna add my own resolutions that I'm gonna use, and I'm gonna use custom timings. Custom timings are not gonna harm your monitor, and in some cases they even work better than the factory set ones. So I'm gonna delete these custom resolutions. And if you have TV resolutions in your data block that's located inside of an extension block, remove this. Just feel free to remove them. And when it comes to audio formats, speaker setups, keep them on. If you have HDMI support, FreeSync range and stuff like that, keep them on. The only thing you really need to remove from data block is just the TV resolutions, and that's it. Alright, now that you're done with that, you pretty much stripped your monitor of the resolutions. It's the same principle of stripping down a Windows so it runs faster. You disable all the unnecessary stuff. That's the same thing we're doing right now. Now let's start. If you have a 60Hz monitor, you're gonna do 60Hz most probably for your display scaling. If you play games like Counter-Strike and you play on very low resolutions, you can enable these four resolutions, because then it's gonna display scale on 75Hz and it works on 99% 60Hz monitors without any issue. Now, because this is a 144Hz monitor and this works for 144 and up, so disable these four. You're not gonna use 75Hz if you have a gaming monitor, right? So in order to start display scaling, you need to set your monitor's native resolution. Now we're gonna add native resolution. In this case, it's 1920 by 1080, and we're gonna do 60Hz, even though it's a gaming monitor. Now let me explain you why we're doing this. If you put 144Hz here, your monitor should boot just fine. But in case something bad happens and your monitor just refuses to boot up because, for example, Windows didn't pick the proper resolution, you're gonna have issue. We're gonna have to either restart this into the safe mode and then reset the settings you applied and do everything over again, and that's gonna be a pain in the ass. So we're gonna do the safer method. We add 1080p 60Hz resolution with exact reduced timings, and your monitor should boot into 60Hz always without any issues, because gaming monitors usually come with multiple ports. You have DisplayPort, you have HDMI port and such, and if you plug in the weak HDMI cable, it's gonna default to 60Hz. It should work just fine. Now, we specified this as our monitor's native resolution and the refresh rate. Now, let's start with the part of adding resolutions. If your monitor is 60Hz, add all of your resolutions that you need in here. So you select resolution from the drop-down list, or you type a custom resolution in here and refresh rate you want, and just add them. That's it. If you have a gaming monitor that's 144Hz or more, this is what you're gonna do. You are going to add your gaming resolutions either in here, or you can go in extension block and add them, which is the way I prefer to do it. So we're gonna click on extension block, open it, and now we have detailed resolutions. This tab is basically the same as this one, but the only thing that's different between those two is this tab here tells your monitor what's gonna be its native resolution and refresh rate. And everything that's in extension block, monitor can just read and output. So we're going to add resolutions. Now we're gonna add my real native resolution, which is 1920 by 1080, 144 hertz. And I use exact reduce timings because they work the best for me. And it should work just fine for you. If those timings don't work for some reason, you can play around with them. You can do CVT-RB standard, you can do CVT-RB2 standard, you can do native PC, and if one of those works, you're fine. But I usually recommend exact reduce because they just work the best in my case, and from every other PC I did for people, they say it works just fine. So this is gonna be my native resolution that I'm gonna run on desktop and in some games like Sniper Elite 4. So now let's add resolutions we want to display scale. We click add, and now my resolution in Apex Legends is 1536 by 960. Which is a 1610 aspect ratio resolution. And we're gonna put refresh rate to 144 and timing to exact reduce. And that's it. You added your resolution, that's gonna work. Now I'm gonna show you how to check if your monitor display scales. Once you're done with this, so we told our monitor this is gonna be the native resolution the monitor boots in. Then we have extension block, which is the resolutions the monitor should support. And we added 1080p 144 hertz and 1536 by 960 144 hertz, which is what I use to play games. Now press OK and OK to close custom resolution utility. Now you need to restart your drivers in order to apply this. So you open the CRU folder and you're going to have restart 64. Most of you have 64-bit systems, and if you're not sure what system you have, you can right-click this PC icon, go to properties, and look for your PC system type, which is here, 64-bit operating system. If you have a 32-bit operating system or x86 as they usually write, you're gonna run the normal restart. But like I said, a lot of you are gonna have 64-bit versions, so you need to run restart 64. Now I'm gonna restart my drivers and come back real quick. Alright, my graphics card driver is restarted, and this is the window you're gonna see. If you see your monitor working normally, you don't see any flickering or glitches, you're good to go, and you can press exit. If your monitor does not turn on, you could just have a black screen, it's brick, press F8, and it should restart your settings back to default. Your monitor should turn on just normally. If that doesn't work, you're going to have to restart your PC few times in order to get to the safe mode, and then you're gonna have to open the CRU folder, run reset all, and restart your PC normally, and then everything's gonna work again. Now, if you see flickering on your screen, you're going to have to open CRU, find the resolution you're having issues with, click edit, and play around with timings. Because if you have flickering issues on, let's say, exact reduced, if you switch to, for example, CVT-RB or CVT-RB2, that flickering can be gone, and it's no longer gonna be an issue. If you have a BenQ monitor and you use DIAC or AMA, I think it's called, that can cause flickering issues on stretch resolutions because the monitor doesn't like stretching it out while doing those technologies. So you should disable DIAC and AMA if you're trying to display scale stretched resolutions. I had that issue with one client, we solved pretty easily, so it was just those two, and he said he doesn't really notice a difference with DIAC off in Apex Legends. So if he says that, I'll believe him because he's a competitive player. Now how do you check if you're display scaling? Now this is what you can do. You go to display settings and you select your main monitor. Since I have only one, I just scroll down and click on advanced display settings. Now, as you can see, we set our monitor to be 1080p 60Hz as a native resolution, which is what Windows automatically picked after driver restart. Now, in order to properly display scale, please don't use your driver settings to change resolutions, and don't change resolution here. Just don't do it. You go to advanced display settings, you go to display adapter properties, and then you go to list all modes. Now, this is gonna read resolutions directly from your monitor. Now, the resolution that we didn't add are gonna be GPU scaled because monitor doesn't have an EDID file to read, so it doesn't know what timings to use nor what how many pixels to display. But we added 1536 by 960 at 144 hertz. Now I'm gonna select this resolution, press OK, and apply that. Now, if you applied your resolution, you might see this thing. So, as you can see, your desktop resolution changed. It's the one you just set it to, 1536 by 960 in my case, and 144 hertz. But, as you can notice, it's not display scaled. The signal that my monitor outputs doesn't match desktop resolutions. And this is gonna be probably an issue with a lot of you, and it's really easy to solve. And the reason why this issue happens is your GPU drivers, by default, go to GPU scaling, and that's the default option that's turned on. Now, how do you fix this? On AMD graphics cards, you go to AMD Radeon software, you go to display, and as you can see, my GPU scaling got turned on. All I need to do is disable this and then change my resolution again, and it's gonna work fine. If you have Nvidia GPU, you go to your Nvidia control panel, you go to change resolutions, I think that's what the option is called, I'm gonna put it on the screen, and then you set it to display and apply that. Now I'm gonna disable GPU scaling and change my resolution once more. Alright, I disabled my GPU scaling and I reverted back to native resolution for now. Now, when you set the display scaling, if you want to be sure that you're always display scaling, you can do one really cool trick. You have scaling mode, that's what it's called on AMD, and I'm pretty sure it goes the same for Nvidia. You have full screen, you have preserved aspect ratio, and you have no scaling. So on Nvidia, you're gonna put no scaling, and on AMD, you're gonna put center, which means your GPU is never gonna scale any resolution. That's the easy way to confirm that your monitor display scales, because if you open a game and the game runs at, let's say, stretch resolution, but the screen is centered like this, that means the GPU scaling is working and it's centering the image. It's not display scaling, right? But if you display scale, the image should stay stretched without any issues. If you have black bars by any chance, you need to open your monitor settings and play around with them, because a lot of them are set to output just a normal 69 aspect ratio. So sometimes you need to change it to full so the monitor stretches out the resolution. Now let's check if it's gonna display scale. So we go back to advanced display settings, we open the properties from the monitor, and we change our resolution. So in this case, 1536 by 960. And apply. Alright, I changed my resolution, and as you can see, everything is matched. So my desktop resolution is 1536 by 960, and my active signal resolution, which is the monitor resolution, is 1536 by 960. This means you have successfully display scaled, and everything works just fine. Like I said, if you have any graphical artifacts, you need to open CRU and play around with your resolution timings. Or if you have a BenQ monitor and you see glitches, it's probably because of either DIAC or AMA. Try playing around with those and see how it works. Now, this is basically it. This is how you display scale, and this works just fine. If you have Windows 8.1 or Windows 7, you probably don't have a window like this. So what's the other way to confirm if your monitor display scales? You can do it with your on-monitor display settings. I'm gonna show you how it looks on mine. Now, since I'm on the phone, the camera might be a little bit shit, but in order to check on your monitor if it display scales, so you go to your monitor on screen display settings, and on ViewSonic it should look like this. Now what you need to do is you need to find information tab, some call it resolution or info statistics, and you open that tab. Now as you can see, my monitor shows resolution 1536 by 960, 144 hertz. That means I'm display scaling, and that's it. That's how you verify if you're display scaling on older Windows systems. If you have Windows 10, you could just do this method and call it a day. That's it. Thanks for watching this video. See you.